What are the chemicals, the harmful chemicals that you're most concerned about right now, in particular relative to their impacts on children? Has that changed over the years, or has it stayed fairly consistent?
The chemicals that we're most concerned about, let's talk about it from the standpoint of brain-based disorders right now. So like ADHD and autism. One way to think about it is, where have the scientists agreed on those toxic chemicals that are most important? So for brain-based disorders, we could look at what Project Tender has been doing. And we came up with the following chemicals of particular concern: air pollution, lead, PBDEs, which are a type of flame retardant, organophosphate pesticides, and phthalates. We could add to that some other chemicals, but that's a good place to start. And what those all have in common is that we have good evidence, sufficient evidence to say that they are toxic to the developing brain. The exposures are widespread. This is not just one community that's being exposed. It's virtually all of us around the world, all children and all pregnant women around the world. So I think that's a good place to start when we think about children. We could come up with other lists for adults, for workers, and so on, but that's a good place to start.
And many of those are those persistent compounds, those, right? The persistent compounds that stay with us for long, very long periods of time.
One of the real strengths of Silent Spring and Rachel Carson's work is it really did force us to move away from persistent chemicals like DDT.
Right.
We haven't done that completely. We've got these new forever chemicals, the PFAS chemicals, but there was a general shift. But it didn't solve the problem, because we moved, for example, from DDT to organophosphate pesticides to control insects and pests. And because we're exposed every day to organophosphate pesticides, whether it's in our diet or in the house dust for children or in our gardens, that they essentially act like they're persistent. The exposures are chronic, and we don't get breaks for them. And that's really where we worry about these toxic chemicals. It's in the constant exposures and constant wear and tear that they lead to.
Right. The barrage, I guess, if you will, on the, yes, on the human body and the accumulation. You know, one of the things I remember is when BPA, this would have been, well, let's see, my son is 17. So at 17 years ago, I was certainly aware of BPA and in baby bottles and using glass bottles, actually, for babies at that point. But we also know, to your point, that when we replace BPA with, say, a BPS, we don't know that it's not as bad, in fact, as BPA, but maybe in a different way, right? So those replacements, just as you're saying, are not always better.